Welcome to the After Action Report. My name's Eric. I'm a personal injury lawyer in South Florida. My passion is helping my injured clients get great results and sharing those experiences with attorneys like you to help you get great results too. Today, we're going to be talking about what an After Action Report actually is and how you can do one with your team after every significant event in litigation or after a trial. Stick around because at the end of this video, I'm going to share with you a link for a template that you can download so that you can conduct your own After Action Review with your team. Before we get into the topic today, if this is your first time watching one of our videos and you're interested in learning about unconventional litigation and trial tips and strategies, go ahead and get started now by clicking on that subscribe button and also hit the little bell icon so you can receive notifications each time we upload a new video, which we do each week. So after every significant event in litigation, whether it's an evidentiary hearing or a jury trial, my team gets together and conducts an after action review to look at different aspects of that trial and to see what worked, what didn't work, and how we can improve for our next case. And the goal for me as a personal injury lawyer is to continually improve the way that I practice law so that I can provide the best representation for my clients. Some of the things that we look at in an after action review is the trial preparation in the months leading up to trial. And we look at what motions in limine were filed and what other motions in limine could we have filed to help our case. We look at deposition designations that were filed and used at trial and could we have filed other depositions that would have impacted the outcome. We also look at jury selection and what questions we asked the jurors and how they responded, and we discuss other questions that we can ask at our next case. We also look at opening statements and closing arguments and look at the demonstrative evidence that we used and our opposing counsel used and look at what was most effective. And the list goes on and on, from studying the jury instructions, verdict form, and also looking at the basic logistics of how we got to the courthouse, where our meals came from, and basic preparation. And the critical aspect of every after action report is writing down the things that you learned during trial and then making a list of action items that you need to take for your next case and then following through with those action items to improve your next trial. And if you prepare an after action report after every significant event in litigation and after trial, you're going to develop a list of best practices to help you win your cases. So I'm going to leave a link to the after action newsletter in the notes section of this video where you can sign up for a copy of the newsletter and receive a template for how you can do an after action report yourself. That's all we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you got some value from it, go ahead and click on that like button. Also, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, click on that subscribe button and the little bell icon so you can receive notifications each time we upload a new video, which we do on trial tips and strategies each week. Looking forward to seeing you next time. Stay safe, stay healthy. We'll see you at the next After Action Report.